First of all, big thank you to all of you taking out time, coming here on Saturday evening. So big thank you to all of you with a big gratitude. Another thank you not to Mr. Nair, sir. I think he always pushed me and pulled me to come here, and that is why this evening talk. I think before we talk on the ethics at workplace, as a researcher, I always draw a boundary. So this is a boundary. It's limited to ethics at workplace. So I will be not talking about politics and country, no. We'll talk first about our house. That house is our company, right? So at workplace. And this talk is basically my experience and exposure and my understanding. So I always say perception differs. So somewhere if you don't agree with me, I'll be all right. And somewhere you agree with me, I'll be very happy, right? So at least chemistry is matching, right? So keep that thought with you. So everybody here with mind? I'm doubting you. Still you are outside, okay? I think before we start a talk, I'm giving you 30 seconds. And this 30 seconds, you have to close your eye and you have to count 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 30. Now, during this count, if you get any thought, tomorrow I have to do that, you go back to 1. Okay? Any thought comes, you have to go back to 1. Are you ready? So close your eyes. Start counting 1 to 30. If any thought disturbs you, again go back to 1. Please start. Your time starts now. Your eyes should be closed. Okay, you can open your eyes. How many of you reach 3030? Really? Not a single thought came in your mind? Genius. How many had a challenge to go up to 30? Raise your hands. Okay. So I'm giving you this homework, today evening talk. Do it seriously when you go back home. And count 1, 2, 3, up to 30. Any thought comes, you go back to 1. Majority telling that they have reached 30, but I have my own question that really, okay, so this is a homework. So I take you granted you are here with your mind, okay? Yes or no?
Yes.
Okay. So keep your mind open. I think it will allow you to add. This is my hot favorite picture. Before I talk, deliver, anywhere I go, this is my favorite picture. I'm delighted that you have energy, you have courage, you put a lot of effort. But I always say that check your purpose and direction. I think this is very important. And this talk is aligned today with your purpose and direction. If this talk helps you to check your purpose and direction, my job is done. Okay? So effort and courage is important, but much more is purpose and direction. So mind well. Okay. So moving further, I think we'll be talk a lot today. That is why I said you are here with mind. And in between, I'll check you that you don't sleep. That's my job. Okay. But I'm a corporate guy, so my eyes are different compared to others. So this is the talk of the evening. What is business ethics? Why business ethics? Challenges and opportunities and benefits. Interesting videos. And question time. So let us start. What is business ethics? And Mr. Gandhi really, you know, set the, you know, the real environment. Whose job is ethics, right? He put it. So we'll talk about it. It's a very interesting question. So let me ask you, what comes to your mind when somebody say ethics? What comes top of your mind? Honesty. Values. Morals. Truthfulness. Principles. Dedication is ethical. Okay, I'm dedicated, but I'm doing a lot of corruption then. You're getting it? So, just again, one more thought process to you guys. Morals, values, character, and ethics, everything is different. Ethics is universal. Moral is country-based. Culture is country-based. Character sometimes is country-based, but ethics is universal. Okay, so keep that thought in your mind. And if you ask me, what comes to the mind? If you ask a global citizen, we are global citizen, right? So these are the thought. And these are thoughts endorsed by big people. The ethics is doing what is good and right for the company. When we are talking topic at workplace, doing good and right. Only doing good is not ethical. And only doing right is also questionable. Right? So good and right is a combination, is ethics. Ethics is basically a process of applying judgments about what is right or wrong in a business situation. So we'll have a case study today. It will be a short case study, don't worry. And it is also a treating others the way you want to be treated. You got it? So, three thoughts about ethics. Now, how many of you are working in a company? Raise your hand. How many of you are entrepreneur? Raise your hand. So, either you are working in a company or you are running the company. So, for me, you are a right target audience. So, work ethics is basically invisible. If I meet you or if you meet me, you cannot make the judgment about me in 30 minutes or 10 minutes. I am ethical or unethical. But this statement valid. It's invisible behavior. Noticeable by its absence. So, thoda aur baat karenge. Couple of questions if you are working in a company. Can be like this, what is presented in the presentation. What to do? My boss is hiring a like-minded people. Now, like-minded people into bracket, questionable. Ethics is becoming a question in my company. Can be the statement. Or look at this lady. I find few employee of my company disclosing confidential customer data to our competitors. I don't know, but the flashes. And there are many flashes. Maybe somebody is playing with the company expense report. Somebody is using company's resources for his or her advantage. Many things, many flashes if you work in a company or if you are running a company, right? These are all moment of truth. You pass in and out every day. So all these issues are addressing a common workplace ethics, which is an evening talk today. And ethical problems are inevitable in all level of business. I think end of the talk, you will get a bigger picture. Let us do a small case study. Are you ready? Yes. So let us read it together and then I will look forward for your responses. Let us say you are Mr. Ankur, okay? And you are a manager in a very big company. And you are also doing part-time MBA, okay? And his company is new and he was assigned by his boss to select a chartered accountant, okay, to conduct an audit. Now, one of this Ankur's professor got a information that Ankur's company need the chartered accountant for the audit. So professor contacted Mr. Ankur and told Ankur that I am interested to do the audit of your company. And even if I have to give you something, I'm all right. I know it's a customary to get an entry into a company assignment, right? So Ankur got this situation and he decided that audit will go to the professor. एंड बाई डूइंग दिस आई थिंक ही विल हैव एडवांटेज, राइट? सो प्रोजेक्ट करना पड़ता है ना, MBA में ऑल दिस फैसिलिटीज विल बी पॉजिटिव टू हिम, राइट? सो सपोज यू आर ए अंकुर, डू यू थिंक वॉट अंकुर इज थिंकिंग इज राइट एप्रोप्रिएट? यू हैव टू स्पीक समथिंग, नो? ओके, बट सपोज यू वॉन्ट टू introduce professor to your company, will you introduce? Yes or no?
Yes.
So this situation happens, right? If he is proper for the, and he got a talent or experience, right? So this type of situation, this case study number one, we will have total three, two balance. If I am Ankur, politely I will tell professor, thank you so much sir, you are my guru, and I don't think this is a right offer, okay, to pay commission. We don't do, we are ethical company. However, my boss has given me this task, so I will not be selecting you. I will introduce to my company and I will disclose my boss also that you are my professor, so there is no conflict of interest. You got it? And let my boss decides what you said is right. So you have to mind well. This type of situation is a part of life if you are working. And even if you are running a company as an owner, you have to think like this. You can't pull this type of situation in your company because you have to lead by example. Clear? So you will have this type of situation. Let's go for case study two. Ready? Sublock? Listen carefully. Mr. Jay is a warehouse manager responsible for receiving and inspecting vendor parts. And Jay is a head of the quality. So by his position, he was making tough for the vendor to get that part accepted. Okay. So this vendor realized that this is a challenging situation. So what vendor started doing, you know, he invited Jay for a great dinner and lunch and party. So vendor began inviting Jay to dinner and making some recurring cash payments. Don't look at me, I am not Jay. Yeah? Okay. So as the time went by, Jay began to notice the quality of the parts supplied by this vendor was coming into a quality issue. So what Jay did, he told vendor that this is not acceptable. And vendor said, thank you so much. I paid you too much. We enjoyed too much. I have plenty of records about you, what you did with me. I will tell your boss. You got it? I will tell your boss that last 2 years you were eating me. Now it's my time. So you are a friend of Mr. Jay. Okay, and you are watching this situation. You are working together, not only friend. You are working together and you are watching what you will do. Question to all of you. You and Jay are working together. So what you will do now? Dekho, ye koi badi political game nahi hai. Work ethics ka baat ho raha hai. To aap kya karoge? Then? Stop it. Okay.
He should be advised that first he should apologize to his organization that whatever I did was wrong. If you still continue to keep me, then I will make sure that in future I will not indulge into anything of such sort.
Excellent, excellent, Gandhi Saab.
Even though vendor is blackmailing him, he can straightforwardly say no at the cost of his job.
Excellent, at the cost of the job. So you are realizing what I'm selling you, the thought process. It's not you. You are ethical. But you see a lot of unethical act. It's your job, right? To coach, counsel, consult, report, right? It's important, right? Maybe you can tell Jay that, rightly said, that better go together to the management and then you agree or you accept that, okay, these are the misconduct and I have taken the advantage of the company and I'm ready to resign and I'm ready to correct my mistakes, right? I was unethical. You rightly said, right? So this type of situation. And this topic is very interesting. Let's go to case study 3. Ready, Sublok? Okay, let us read case study number 3. Petty cash rehta hai company mein, you know that. So a cashier at the local store was engaged. Engaged means uska engagement hua tha. And was preparing for his wedding day. He expected the total cost of the wedding to range from 25,000 to 30,000. Chota aadmi hai, toh cost is also small. He expected the total cost of wedding is 25,000 to 30,000. So cashier has only been working for a short time. So even he was saving money, but he has not accumulated so much of money. So what he did, you know, he was assumed to take the money from his parents. So his friend gave him the loan of 25,000, 30,000. And what he did, you know, he put this money to the stock market. And unfortunately, stock market crumbled and he lost all the money. So he was handling the petty cash. So he said that, why can't I take money from the petty cash? Nobody will question him because he's the head of the petty cash. So he took this money from the petty cash of the company and invested in the stock market. Now the time was good. He made the money. And again, he deposited money back to the petty cash. So there is no issue to the company also, right? And now you are watching him. And you are also the accountant in the company. Suppose you are the accountant and you watch this chronology, what you will do? देखो ऐसा भी होता है. That is why case study, right? What you will do?
Immediately informing the management.
Okay. I am you and I close friend, okay? You are accountant and I am a cashier. Very close friend, family relation. I go emotionally with you.
I can give notice to him that henceforward you will not take any money from the petty cash. Otherwise, I will inform the manager.
Okay.
Still, I will inform the top management.
No, I'm taking you emotionally now. Mind well, very clearly. You and I don't know more than few minutes, but let's say you and I have a close family bad bonding. I said, "Kuch bhi karo, yar. Ghar ka aadmi hai, yar. Aisa thodi karega, yar." I will not do next time.
According to saying this, he said he should give the last warning. That these things should not occur again, or he will report to the
top management. हाँ, आपको कुछ बोलना है? Okay.
Personal life is different. Professional life is different.
Personal life is different and professional life is different. But he has violated, right, in this case.
But in this case, before even violation, he could have thought of asking the...
So that is a remedial advice that he would have done like this. It's a post-mortem, right? The event has happened.
There would be some policy kind of thing that if something happened that cashier will take some amount, then there will be a back-to-back policy or something like that.
But it's a mid-size or a small company, so... No, yeah. Okay.
Accountant should acknowledge this to the management. At the same time, should recommend him to pardon with a memo.
Okay. So I'm very happy to listen all sort of advices, because you are advising me and I am in trouble. This case study for me. Now just introspect your advices versus moral, culture, character, principle, value, ethics. And I said ethics is universal, right? So if you say that I have to take an ethical decision, I think a couple of advice is correct. That first and foremost, I would like to go together with him to the management and tell entire story. And I'll tell management it is the choice we have to take, or it is a decision we have to take. If you want to give a chance, It's a collective decision. It's not one man emotional family or two people family bonding, right? So this type of thing is happening, is going to happen, and we have to handle it, right? Workplace at ethics is a big talk. But just tips of iceberg we are discussing. You are getting a thought process clear? Okay, let's move. So when we are working in a company, whatever is the size, small, medium, or a big company, multinational, we will have this type of dilemma. Right, wrong, good, right, not this. You know, so recognize this type of challenges in day-to-day job. Maybe get the facts that what happened, why this happened, where this happened, what is the impact on my company, and maybe work out a lot of options, and then if you are a boss, make the decision, or you consult the people. But you have to take a call. What all we are talking right now, internal matter, petty cash, vendor parts, I'm not talking outside, maybe government officers and tender, etc. That's a separate story. Many, many incidents is happening. Running a company today, and you're working with many minds, right? So this is very important topic. Now, are you ready to listen to a videos? Yeah. Sab log ready ho? Thoda American English rahega. So maybe listen carefully, and we'll also talk post the video. Ready, sab log? Before I go to this video, I'll just give you some clarity. This lady is worth listening, and I was impressed. Worth listening, I was impressed. Listen to her carefully. Every word, W-O-R-D, is important in the context of ethics at work. Okay? And somewhere if I have to take a pause, I'll take a pause to give you more time to read what she's telling.
So I got an email last week from the conference organizer. It said, good news, you're going after Van Jones. And I thought, in whose alternate universe is it a good thing to follow Van? And then I remembered, I'm here to talk about courage. Our ability to act from our hearts in the face of fear. And courage as a skill that we can build with practice. So thank you for this tremendous opportunity to practice. First, let's take a look at what does life look like without courage?
The Enron fraud is the story of synergistic corruption. There are supposed to be checks and balances in the system. The lawyers are supposed to say no. The accountants are supposed to say no. The bankers are supposed to say no, but no one who was supposed to say no said no.
So has anything changed in the last 10 years? And please raise your hands when you've had enough. Yeah, me too. And it doesn't have to be this way. What if the people in these circumstances had the courage and the skills to act on their values in the face of fear? I met a man who did in exactly one of those types of circumstances. We'll call him Ted. He found an illegal trading ring in his department, and he didn't know what to do, so he did nothing. And as the days passed and the stress built, he decided he would have to quit. He confided in his friend in another department, and his friend said to him, if you went into the system, could you find the program? And Ted said yes. And his friend said, then you have no choice. And what Ted says is he was reminded of who he was, of his values, in that moment reflected by his friend. So he came forward and justice prevailed. I had my own subtle experience with powerful situations. I was working for a company, and I found out the CEO was doing something unethical and illegal. So I called a meeting with my boss, the CFO, and his other direct reports. In a scenario that looks shockingly like this stock photo, and went to deliver the news, and I knew he would struggle. Although a very ethically driven man, the CEO was also a good friend of his. So I delivered the news, and he looked at me and he said, I think we should do some more research and give it a little time. I was so dumbstruck by the answer that everything went into slow motion like it did when I was a kid playing soccer. And I looked around, and everyone has their head down or is slowly nodding. And I was so perplexed. I know these people, they're good people. And the last thing you want to do is put more time between when you know and when you say in a circumstance like this. So I was confused, but the humbling part of the story for me is then my thought process goes to, maybe we don't have to do anything. Maybe it isn't such a big deal. I don't even have to say anything. And then I was given a gift. The CFO was called out of the room for a minute, and in that moment, I remembered, this is one of those moments. This man hired me because he believed in me. He believed I would do my job and act on our shared values when it was hard. So he came back into the room, I stepped back into time, and I said, we should go to the board. And he paused, and he looked at me, and he nodded, and we did. But what I will never forget is that I am, and we all are, vulnerable to situational influence all the time. It's just natural human wiring.
Thanks for sharing that.
This from our founder, Dr. Phil Zimbardo. He found this out in 1971 when he conducted the famous Stanford Prison Experiment that showed that even the most ethical and compassionate among us can easily betray our values in the face of a challenging situation. I won't make you raise your hands for this one, but think back over the last 6 months. How many of you have been in a situation where you thought, someone should do something, or I should say something? And think of the subtle ones, because those are often the ones that get us. And you and no one else did anything. It's natural. It's a natural human tendency to be a bystander, to follow a leader or a group that we know is doing something wrong for a sense of acceptance or a sense of security. The good news is we get to choose. But it's first, it's even harder for us.
Unethical conduct happens because people are unconsciously fooling themselves. If you look at this lady, the way she started, confidence. Even there were problems, everybody had down, but they were nodding. That's what she's talking is right, right? So this is what is a challenge. She said this challenge will be everyday challenge. Even she asked a very critical question that last 6 months you are working in a company. How many times you felt that, you know, something going wrong and I must speak up, and but you have not speaked up? And almost all the hands were up. Now this is a gravity. Okay, this is a gravity. She's talking at this platform. Okay. And that's why she said that there are lapses in the action in the corporate world. Seems too so pervasive and intrusible. Right? So listen to her further.
Yes. In business to do the right thing. Research out of Harvard on ethical fading shows that when we're focused on operational objectives and you throw pressure on top, sound familiar? The ethical implications of our acts will fade from our minds. Pay attention when people say, this is business. Find out what they mean when they say that. So now the good news is we get to choose. Between stimulus and response, there is a space. And our work is about using that space to get us to reconnect to our values, to our hearts, to our natural wisdom, to act courageously. The kids in our program call it the magic pause button. The way we do that is we use something called social fitness training. It was developed over 25 years by Dr. Lynn Henderson. And the great news about it is, with practice, we can actually retrain our brains to override our natural fear response to act consistently from on our values in the face of fear. Start to think the key aspects of her work to remember. Start to recognize your patterns. Where do you stand up easily and where do you not? Once you know your patterns, practice the situations that scare you. We call them social flight simulations. And just like with pilots, if you practice with some level of fear, it creates the muscle memory so that when the actual moment arises, you can act in the way that you've practiced. You start to use that shot of fear or adrenaline as your cue for mindful action versus avoidance. In neuroscience, they call it priming the brain. So how do we foster these ethically courageous corporate cultures? Become a pattern interrupter. Start to interrupt your own patterns. Create your own pause button. Create it for your teams and your organizations. I think if we can all agree, if we look at the challenges facing our economic system, our political system, and the world at large, we're going to need a bigger pause button. What I also know by our work is that we're all born with the innate capacity for courage. It's a choice, one I hope we'll all make, and it matters. Thank you.
Was this lady impressive? I think she pinpointed upfront, one is the confidence and courage. She openly told all of us that we know what is good and right, but we don't talk courageously. We don't use the courage because, and she said that when people say, this is a business, be careful. You heard her? Very carefully. If somebody said, this is a business, be careful. She gave one more advice. Stimulus, response, and there is a space. If you get some situation, it's a stimulus. Don't react or respond. Take time in this type of situation. I'm talking ethics at workplace. Take some time and give an appropriate response. Don't be in a hurry. Even her own example in this video that she know that her CEO is doing something unethical and she told her boss is a CFO, chief finance officer, and chief finance officer reaction was, okay, give me some time, we have to investigate. You are getting me? And then she felt very bad and then she used some other sources and then reported, right? And even ask a question that this type of situation is day in and out. I don't know for you or for me, but just take this as a introspective part of our evening talk. Okay, we'll have one more video later, right? And now you understood that why this topic, right? Business ethics at workplace. Your brand value is big, right? Company's brand. So company's name is valuable. Why you join ABCD company? Because you value the brand. Tata is a respectable brand. Infosys is a respectable brand, right? And you joined them. And you joined because you value this brand, into bracket, you value a lot of things, right? And ethics is part of it. That Tata will not do something wrong, right? Tata will not force me to take wrong decisions. How many of you is in finance or handling finance department? If you are a chartered accountant, you will understand how company push you to take a call on couple of subject. So company, many years in the market, and even one incident, Nestle company, you know, their favorite product, you know, what is that? Now you understand? One report by food inspector on non-compliance. Non-compliance, the bigger picture is playing the health of public. You are getting a stuff now. Ethical, unethical is a later part. It's a debatable, they are fighting. But look at the impact of the stock value from the day it happened and today. Impact is there, right? Visible. If you are investing in a stock, you understand what I want to convey, right? So if this happens to the workplace where I am working, and if you want to change a job, you said you were in that company in newspaper, Sorry, you're getting it now. It's not only company brand, it's me also and you also, where you work. It has a big, big impact overall, if you take it. Because generally we plan aggressively for 3 years, but we never plan for 15 years. If you plan long term and you take a bigger picture, you understand the impact. Impact in short while, you find it's pretty small. Taking 25,000 from a cash petty case is okay. But no, it's not okay. It's a big subject, right? So there are good news and challenges, and there are some solutions also. So I would like to share as a researcher. A couple of my students has done some job. So three paragraph, but I will take you to the important message, what student in PhD has done. So last year, business ethics survey by my research student in India, with senior executives. And this is, we are doing for last 3 years, 2009, 2013, and now 2015, recent. Now, interestingly, the findings, paragraph 2, the central finding of this research includes the first overall drop in observed misconduct seen 37% in 2013, it has reduced to 17% in 2015. So great achievement. Employee reporting all these ethical challenges or misconduct, which increased to 78% this year from 57% in 2013 and 38% in 2009. So that's a good news that this topic, this subject is becoming dearer to the top management, and not only top management, even investors also. See, company is not only the employee and the CEO, people are investing in the company, right? So very, very interesting finding for me and my student. In addition, perception that top management keeps promises and the commitment, it went up to 71, it was went up from 71% in 2013 to 82% in 2015. I think this was the biggest area in our ethical study. That bolta hai, boss kuch bhi bolta hai, kaam kuch nahi hota hai. There is a code of ethics, there is a ethics training, but I think boss, what all boss say, he don't keeps his promises. Now, even I'm telling you, as a boss, you promise a lot. You promise the work environment, you promise the facility, you promise the incentives, you promise some salary increase, you want promise some ESOPs, whatever, you promise a lot. And employees are very smart. They're listening to you very carefully. And if you don't comply, then you are also not ethical, right? Means you are fooling them. Cheating, na? It's cheating one type of. Moving further, this is, I think, when I was in Mumbai, and this was a flash I collected. Times of India, Mumbai, December 22nd. Ethics and compliance is taking a positive step in this country, which is a good news. I think reading is challenging there, but compliance is gaining in importance, with 62% of Indian organizations having a designated chief compliance officer. Nowadays, they designate a separate officer, ECO, ethics and compliance officer. Great. Their job is to make sure that things are done in good and right way. Right, so that's taking a momentum. If you ask me why we respect certain countries for doing a business like Singapore always gets the higher rank doing business. Why? One of the reason is ethics and compliance. So this is also interesting part of our talk, and it's also interesting part where you are an employer or employee, and if you have this as a part of your grooming, it will help us together. Now moving further on this ethics at workplace, and this is my favorite equation. You say, my company is good in policy, but I don't think people are ethical, they are following it. Now there is a formula. Behavior is a function of you as an individual and the environment we create. An environment is in my control as a CEO, and it is in your control as an employee, so we both are responsible. Mr. Gandhi was asking, whose responsibility? Together we are responsible to build the ethical environment at my workplace. It's not one man job. Yes, top man has to drive it. Top man has to drive it. And this is another favorite statement I always use. First impression is an everlasting impression. First impression is an everlasting impression. If I am your customer and I'm meeting you as a manager, you are manager, I carry the impression, right, about your company. And ethics is central. Even as a customer, I try to play. And today's customers are very smart. Today's customers are very smart. No doubt, we are also smartest as employee and the employer. But you never get a second chance to create a first impression about you and your company. And that's what your shiny eyes will tell me. It's not only the ethics policy and ethics training, but when I look at eyes to eye as a customer and you as an employee or employer, it conveys a lot. Audio video has a relation with the eye contact. Got it? If it is a lady, keep on a center, always an eye to eye. It's difficult sometimes.
No, does it mean that, say, you give the example of Nestle, it has a first impression in your mind, it's the best company, very nicely run company, product is very good. But then the second impression came that it has done something wrong, has been that price has come down. But immediately it regained the old price. That is, first impression is regained.
Absolutely. See, here I'll tell you. You build up your brand over a period. This type of incidents happens. How you handle it? It's situational. How you handle it? And suppose you say that you made a mistake. Accept it openly in the market. If you go back to a couple of automobile company giving a flash that we are now going to recall ABCD, 100,000, 200,000, this many millions of dollars. Why they are doing it? They know that the mistake happened. By R&D or design, whatever, but they recognized it. Customers are okay. Okay, you made a mistake, so you are coming to me, it's all right. But intention, see, my favorite slide, purpose and direction is very, very important. Your purpose and direction is very clear that I will follow the ethical aspect of my business. That's it. You rightly say it. But for Nestle, it's a challenge still to prove it. It's like that. If you are Mr. Clean and somebody say you are not Mr. Clean, it's your job to come back, right? So again, we'll talk about it. It's a challenging part of the ethics at workplace also, right?
You went to 100 to 50, then 80, but still not 100.
Absolutely. So it's challenge also. But homework always plays. If you have a homework, proactive work, culture, everything is there in the company, right? And it's a multinational company. So, and other countries has no complaint except India. So it's again comparable. If you look at Singapore's and other examples they are giving, na? So think other way around, right? So ethics is something that is learned and chosen throughout one's life. So it's always work in progress. I can't say that I'm expert in this field, always work in progress. But you have to follow some standard rules and regulation. So if you're an employer, I think it's your responsibility. And you have to share your expectation in the context of ethics. Moving further, it's two-way job, employer-employee, right? You can't ring a bell, you can't ring a drum like single-handed. You need both the side. This is your example. Okay, you are all here today evening talk. This is your example, right? So if you're having a strong ethics in your personal and professional life, need no explanation, right? You have a choice. Sometimes question comes. By the time employee hit or join your workforce, can they be taught things like ethics? Absolutely, answer is yes. It's never too late. And nowadays, if you join a couple of companies, there is minimum 30 days they have to complete some part of ethics, training and coaching and learning. Without that, they are not given the decision role. Suppose if you are joining a board of directors, then there is a big list to complete. Like if you are a member of IBD, Institute of Board of Directors, IBD is an institute in India, I am a member, there are a couple of jobs you have to, it's part of ethics. I think it's imperative. Anybody joins the company and if you have ethics training module, code of ethics policy, I think do that. It will help us. If you read this slide, it will help us. And again, sometimes, you know, question comes. If somebody asks you a question, what do you mean by professional? If somebody asks you a question, what do you mean by a professional? And they ask you next question, are you professional? I want any one answer. Anybody sitting here, they said that they are professional, raise your hand. Nobody professional? Okay, let me ask you a simple question. If you get an income tax notice relevant to your taxes, whom you will contact? Chartered account. Let us say Bhagwan kare kabhi notice na hai, but you get a legal notice, whom you consult? Maan lo koi throat infection ho gaya, tu kiske paas jaoge? Mere paas kyun nahi aa raha, main bhi doctor hu. You're getting me? The meaning of the professional is the person, he or she, is having a expertise knowledge in his or her field. So you all are professional. What all you are doing in your field, you are professional. You are expert in your field, right? So that is what is part of this. Ethics is also part of professionalism. When you say that holistic part of a professionalism, ye topic important hai, right? It is your code of ethics. Training to dena hi hai. And Google karo, you will get a lot of training modules on ethics. So there is no scarcity of the material. You must, if you are a, whatever size of your company, you must have a written code of conduct. Means ethics. You have to define the ethics and you have to maintain in your organization. I think it's a bigger boundary you have to draw for your employee and yourself. And this is the area to take it forward. I think invest at least 3 to 4 days in a year, scattered, not together, on this topic. If you don't talk this subject, nothing will happen. It's always work in progress. You have to hammer it. And it's a culture building. I always use my standard dialogue. Culture is king. People can copy your product. People can copy your process. But they cannot copy your culture. Right? And ethics is part of the culture. Why people say that, okay, Infosys is a different culture. Tata is a culture. Google is a culture. And your company is a culture. Culture is king. And this is part of the culture. Got it? If somebody joining my company from a Tata group of company, I never ask a single question on ethics. You got it? Take it granted. They are ethical people, they are ethical employee, given enough ethical input. So I need not to worry and ask any question on the ethical side of the business, right? So this is what I want to convey, that you have to invest time and money on this topic. Behavior which is rewarded is repeated, right? So ensure that you find out the super hero and heroines in this area. Call them in public and tell them that what they have done good and right for the company. And that is our job. Behavior rewarded, repeated, right? So this is very important. And you as an employer and you as an employee, this is your job. Be a role model, right? Be a role model. And I'm telling you, people will recollect the right advices. Remember, people will recollect the right advices. And this is an opportunity to all of us, that role model. I'm not telling you that we can, you know, equal to Mahatma Gandhiji, no. But let us be best in class in your work area. Let us be best in class in your work area in this topic. I think this is very interesting, right? We have to continue this journey. Catch them doing good and right. And this is interesting input to all of us in evening topic, that ethics depends on situation. And I know these are the question always, it's situational. In spite of training sessions on ethics, enforcement, but ultimately left to you and me. And now left to you and me is choice, chance, consequences. 3C, choice, chance, consequences. Got it? So you have to remember 3C because you are making a choice, you are taking a chance, and you are ready for the consequences. But there are guidelines, we'll talk about it. If you are an employee, you must comply with standard of your conduct and policy, right? So you know your boundary. Take questions to your compliance officer or ethics officer or your boss and report if you see some gaps, violations, or if you suspect. See, this is a dangerous area, but when you give a confidence to your employee, you can report and it will be confidential. Then I think this subject goes well as a culture building, right? Moving further, what to report? Now question comes, what to report? Now here is a couple of guidelines. What to report? Allegations of wrongdoing. If you suspect actual incident of wrongdoing, example petty cash. Some audit or review findings, you have some concern. Somebody is lying, somebody is cheating, somebody is stealing. Hota hai company mein. And why? Because to stop improper activity, enable corrective actions and visibility. Learn from the and not to repeat. Right. Moving further, this is a very interesting test for the today's topic. First question, is it legal? Check the local law and international law. Second, if it is not illegal, is it in the accordance with my company code of ethics and the policies? What your code say? How it will show on your book? Does it conflict with my employer's policies? And what do you get for your money, right? So a couple of questions you have to ask yourself before making a choice. Now this is beyond. Test for determining if the business practice issue exists. Number one, can we live with this public disclosure? I can say that I am taking petty cash from my company. Can I live with this disclosure? You will laugh at me. You are cheating your company. You got my point. Can I live with this public disclosure? Point number two, if this practice I have started, can it be stopped? Interesting. What will happen to company image and reputation today and future? What is the effect of my six stakeholder? If you Google it, there are six stakeholder. Investors, employees, vendors, competitor, government, likewise. Would you like this done to you? Vendor case study, right? You are the vendor now. Will you like this? So these are either side questions. And when you are in doubt, check with your expert. And there are benefits. I think I need not to repeat this slide, but there are values and the benefits if we have the ethics at workplace. It is there, but we have to populate. We have to make it as an integral part of the culture. That's a talk today. If I have to summarize ethics at workplace, I think this is very important summary. First and foremost, five obligations. Obey the law. Abide by the company policy. Be loyal to your company. Treat others honestly and fairly. And report suspected wrongdoings. Now follow four fundamental rules. Now these are fundamental rules. I think right from our childhood, hum log ye sun ke aa rahe hai. Jhoot mat bolo. Barabar na? Don't cheat. Don't steal. Don't bribe. And be transparent in all your actions, right? Ye hum log right from childhood, this is ingrained in us. So this is something like code of ethics summary. If you refer any code of ethics or policies, I think this is integral part of it. Framed in the nice English or Hindi or Gujarati. But this is interesting, slide. Real ethics or integrity is doing the right thing when nobody is observing you. Then you are ethical. Sabke samne, I will pretend that I am real ethical hero. Because I am acting ethical, because now everybody is watching me. But now the real test of the ethics is that you do the good and right when nobody is observing you. That's a real test. Warren Buffett ka ye statement mujhe yaad hai. बराबर पढ़ लो. दिस इज अ नाइस हिंदी लाइन आई हर्ड फ्रॉम समबडी. नीयत तेरी अच्छी है तो किस्मत तेरी दासी है, कर्म तेरा अच्छा है तो घर में मथुरा काशी है. मुझे अच्छा लगा, मैं बोला डाल देता हूँ मैं इधर. आई थिंक इट विल बी गुड टू शेयर विथ यू गाइस एंड पोस्ट दिस लिसनिंग अंडरस्टैंडिंग. आई थिंक डोंट कीप इट टू द विश लेवल, मेक द डिसीजंस टू बी अ एथिकल प्रोफेशनल. राइट, प्रोफेशनल प्लस एथिकल. आई थिंक दिस इज अ पैटर्न आई थिंक यू हैव टू फॉलो स्लोली इन दिस टॉपिक. कंसीव इट, बिलीव इट एंड देन कंटिन्यू योर जर्नी ऑन द एथिकल साइड. Moving further, if you think that couple of input you really enjoyed, don't keep to the enjoyment level, convert into PDP, personal development plan. And this is a habit, important. Pick up isme se kya mil raha hai, just convert into action. Okay, how you would like to use the today's evening talk input in your career. Finally, personal note, this is a very important topic, that's why we invested together. Return on involvement and return on investment, दोनों सही है, ROI. It will guarantee you sustainable growth. Okay, so this topic is important and it will make you powerful. Mark Twain को मैं याद करता हूँ इधर. Always do the right. Always do the right. Tough है. I think talking is very easy in front of you, but really when I have to practice it, I have to act on it. It's a choice, chance and consequences. So I loudly say three big thank you, thank you, thank you, because it's attitude for gratitude, listening me so nicely, right? Now we open up for a question type.